Well, let's say for now, anyway. They said she was too good for him. She was hardly pounding chick, but Ernie got his cocoa there 3 times every week. They called him Ernie.
Ernie!
He drove the fastest milk car in the West. She said she liked to bathe in milk. He said, all right, sweetheart. And when he finished work one night, he loaded up the car. He said, you wanted pasteurized, because pasteurized is best. She said, Ernie, I'll be happy if it comes up to my chest. That's a good old Ernie.
Ernie!
And he drove the fastest milk car in the West. Now, Ernie had a rival, an evil-looking man. Called two-ton Ted Contellington, he drove the baker's van. He tempered her with treacle tarts and his tasty wholemeal bread. And when she seen the size of his old clothes, it very near turned her head. She nearly swooned in his macaroon. He says, now be treating you right. You'll have hot rolls every morning and crumpets every night. He knew when she sampled his layer of cake, he'd had his wicked way. And he went across to Ernie's car and he did not hit his horse, whose name was Trigger. He's come top of his hat. He said, if you want to marry Susie, you'll fight for her like a man. Oh, why don't we play cards for her? He sneeringly replied. And just to make it interesting, we'll have a shilling on the side. Now, Ernie dragged him from his van beneath the blazing sun. They stood there face to face, and Ted went for his fun. But Ernie was too quick. Things didn't go the way Ted planned. And a strawberry flavored yogurt said, just send him from his hand. Sushi ran between them and tried to keep them apart. And Ernie pushed her aside and a rock cake came underneath his arm. And he looked up in pain, surprised the concrete hardened crust of a stale pork pie grew in the eye, and Ernie bit the dust. Poor Ernie.
Ernie!
And he drove the fastest milk car in the West.
Hey!
Ernie was only 52. He didn't want to die. And now he's got to make deliveries in that new island in the sky, where the customers are angels and ferocious hearts are banned, and a milkman's life is full of fun in that fairy dairy land. But a woman's needs are many-fold, and soon she married Ted. But strange dreams happen on their wedding night as they lay in their bed. Was that the trees are rustling or the inches off the gate? Or Ernie's ghostly gold socks are rattling in their grave? They won't forget.